Gnawa music is your friends, your family, your blood, it's everything. But what is striking is that in the Gnawa music is kind of, now it has been fusing with its spiritual core with art and kind of music like the jazz, the blues, the hip-hop, the reggae. But for me, I think this kind of, while fusing this kind of type of music, the Gnawa music lost its kind of spirituality.
Things are put into question. Oh, am I losing my identity when I borrow Gnawa music? Or if I borrow as a Gnawa the musical mold of this other brotherhood, am I going to bastardize my identity and who I am? I don't think that there is that level of consciousness that goes on when things are not necessarily put into question and things happen naturally over the course of centuries.
A little bit, but do you think that the festival represents Moroccan identity?
You mean now?
Yeah.
Actually, no.
And if you can get some medical or spiritual thing out of it, all the better. But if you don't, then it's just for me. I'm not sure. It's necessarily disrespectful, and it's taking something real and bastardizing it. You see them walking by your neighborhood, you know, begging for alms, and they'll play something and you have to tip them. I'm not sure to which extent they were all really Gnawa. You know, I'm not sure they were members of actual brotherhood. They had been initiated, they were, you know, I'm not sure that was the case.
These kind of two kind of instruments that we would use is better for me than these kind of new instruments. Because of these new instruments, I mean the Gnawa music, it loses its spirituality for me.
music is almost as much a medical instrument as a stethoscope or something. So a stethoscope around the neck of a doctor, guess what it's meant to do? But when it's lying on a table in his living room, then it's not real anymore. It's very tempting to think.